Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. In the previous video, you covered interpolation between keyframes, as well as refining the animation curve by adjusting the keyframe tangents. In this video, you'll go through some additional tools in the Tools pull-down menu to give you extra control when working with keyframes in the animation editor. I'm picking up from the previous video, but if you'd like to follow along, just use a simple graphic to create a few animation curves like mine, and you're good to go. Now, for the most part, you have been using the Select tool in the Tools menu, which you generally use for selecting and moving keyframes in the animation editor. As a reminder, you can pick up a keyframe and move it in any direction, or you can hold Shift, and this will constrain the keyframe either vertically or horizontally. Now, if you wanted to add additional keyframes to the curve, you could use Auto Key or the Set Key button as covered in the previous videos, but you could also open the Tools pull-down menu and simply choose Add Points. This allows you to interactively click on the curve and add additional keyframes wherever you like. Just be aware that if you click and drag with this tool, you'll add a keyframe, but it also allows you to move the keyframes which directly affect the animation curve. So this is just a quick additional method of adding keyframes. Inversely, if you wish to delete keyframes quickly, go to the Tools pull-down menu and choose Delete. Using this cursor, just click on a keyframe and it's gone. You can click on a single keyframe or create a box selection with Control to delete multiple keyframes. This is different to resetting an entire channel, where you would select the channel and click the Reset Channel button. Now, Select, Add Points, and Delete are probably the most frequently used tools when it comes to animation. But there are also a range of other tools that could be very useful to you. For example, the Select tool allows you to select and move keyframes in one tool. However, there are instances where you may want to select a keyframe but not move it with the cursor. So open the Tools pull-down menu and choose Select Points. When you click on a keyframe, you can select it, but there is no chance of accidentally moving it in the animation editor. Ideally, you keep the value of the keyframe, but maybe change its interpolation from Bezier to Linear. Now, another scenario, which comes up often, is that you have a selection of keyframes and you would like to manipulate them without ever losing the selection. For example, select a few keyframes on the curve. To lock the selection, you click the Tools pull-down menu and choose Translate. You can now click anywhere in the animation editor and move your keyframes. You will not lose the selection, even if you are clicking and dragging elsewhere on the curve. You can also use the constraints with Shift and make minor adjustments without losing the selection. Just remember to switch back to Select if you want to add or deselect keyframes from the selection. The last two tools I want to cover in this video is the XScale and YScale tools. Click the Tools pull-down menu, and you will find them towards the top of the list. What is handy about these tools is that they allow you to scale the spacing between the keyframes based on the cursor's position on the curve. For example, choose the XScale tool and go to the first keyframe on the curve. When you click and drag, you can see how all the keyframes scale away or towards the first keyframe. If you were to perform the same operation on a keyframe in the middle of the curve, the surrounding keyframes will either move away or closer towards the chosen keyframe. So XScale depends on which keyframe you click on as you scale the curve. So the animation is happening faster or slower depending on the spacing between the keyframes. If you were to switch to the YScale tool using the Tools pull-down menu, the same principles will apply with choosing a keyframe and scaling. The big difference is instead of horizontally increasing or decreasing the amount of time, you are vertically scaling the intensity of the animation within the selected channel. So this concludes the tools I wanted to show you in this video. However, one thing you should also know is that this view is not the only way in which you can view animation. In fact, this is known as the channels view, and there are two more views that you'll discover in the next video. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel and click the bell to be notified for future videos. Thanks for watching, and hope to see you soon.